Issa, come too close. Welcome to our channel. Sage, you say hi. I'm only getting views because of Sage. Take three. Hi guys, so thanks for coming to watch another one of my random videos. I'm gonna be doing more videos in this lockdown. Really to keep me sane, because how am I meant to cope? So I've asked, done a little poll thing on my Instagram story, and then I got a few questions from there. Well, I got quite a lot actually. I don't know if I'm gonna do them all. I'm just gonna go ahead and answer. It's a bit like a get to know me Q&A thing. You probably already know me. It's probably like only about five of my friends who are gonna watch this, but ignore that jingling noise. It's just Sage. So the first one is, how old are you? So I am 20. I look about 16, but I am 20. I'm 21 in Feb, so I've got one more month left of being 20. And then I'm the big 21 in lockdown. How exciting. Yeah, got nothing planned for that. I was gonna go for a meal in Liverpool actually. Yeah, but probably isn't gonna happen. Thanks, Boris. So yeah, I'm 20. If you could live anywhere in the world, where would it be? So I am gonna say something random, like Sage, I'm trying to do a video. Sorry, where in the world would you live? I am gonna say like the Maldives, you know. But do you know what? Without sounding stupid, well, it probably does sound stupid, but there's not like an astro or anything, is there? Like, do you know, like here where we live in that, you get in the car and you go like the shops to Asda, Tesco, Sainsbury's, Morrison's, wherever you go. When you think about it, when people are putting like videos and that on of the Maldives, do you ever see like a supermarket in Asda? Or do you, when you just want to get some chocolate, there's not like a petrol station, is there? Well, there probably is. No, there's not. There's not. There's actually not. I've just seen loads about the Maldives. There's nothing there. There might be like the odd supermarket, because and restaurants, because you've got to eat. But I wouldn't be being able to afford like going to a restaurant every night. Now, if I could go on holiday anywhere, I'd go to the Maldives. That's the plan for the end of next year, or maybe the end of the year later, the year after, if we're out of lockdown. But anyway, if I could live anywhere, I might go to Australia. Because we went to Australia when I was 10. And that was insane. The weather was gorgeous. Yeah, I might go to Australia. I don't think I'd want to go to America, because you have to pay for you have to pay for healthcare in Australia, don't you? I don't know, you're just testing me now. Probably Australia. Or like, yeah, I'm just going to say Australia. Are you excited to become a mum? And what are you most excited about on your mum journey? So, oh yeah, I haven't really announced that. I'm gonna be a mama. Well, I have on me Instagram and Facebook, but by the way, this isn't my phone. Like a pure iPhone 7, this is my old one. And don't mind my nail gone missing. I get too distracted. Yeah, I am so excited to become a mum. I feel like I was born to be a mum, if that's even a thing. So excited. The baby's room's like, it's nearly done. I'm just gonna get it all painted and like decorated nice for him. I'm having a boy. His pram's arriving tomorrow, so that's so exciting. Do you know what? I go out and I'll see like an outfit for me, and it'd be like £25 in Zara or something, and I'm like, no way am I spending that much money on an outfit like for me. And then I'll go into like another shop and it'll be like a dead cute outfit for like 40 quid, and I'm like, oh, that's so cheap for the baby, I'll go and get that. So priorities and all that. So yeah, I am so excited. Like, as you've probably seen on my Instagram, all I post about is the poor baby. Sorry to everyone who's not interested, but best get used to it. And what are you most excited about for the journey? Probably meeting him, you know. Like, obviously as soon as I've met him then, but I just want to know what he's gonna look like. And we've got a 4D scan next month, so we'll have like some sort of idea of his little face and stuff. But just to meet him and to see like what he's gonna be like, because me and Elliot, we've both got dark hair and he's got green eyes, I've got brown eyes, so it's like he's hopefully gonna be like nice and tanned with dark hair. But then my mum's ginger, so I could come off ginger. No offence to new gingers or nothing, but do you know what I mean? I want them to be dark like me. But so yeah, that's what I'm most excited about. I need to stop rambling on because this is gonna go on for about half an hour. What's your biggest fear? So my biggest fear is dying. Obviously I know everyone dies and I know like one day it's gonna happen, but the thought of it just petrifies me. Like, what happens? Like, where do we go? Like, no one really speaks about it, do they? Like, when you die, nothing happens. Or like other people will say, like, when you die, you go to heaven or whatever, but there's no proof of nothing. Like, what happens? Like, before you're born, you don't exist, do you? You've got nothing, you haven't got your soul, you haven't got anything. And then you're made and you're born, you have a life. So when you die, where does your soul go? Like, I do believe in all like the soul stuff and that. But like, what happens? Like, I need like a plan in my head of what's going to happen. I need to know what's going to happen. Like, where do I go? Do I need a ticket or something to like get in anywhere? Like, do you know what I mean? So that's a big fear. And then my biggest other fear is spiders. I think that's every girl's fear. But I am literally petrified. If I see a spider, I don't know why, but I can wake up in the morning and look in a certain spot in my bedroom and there'll be a spider there. And it'll be the first place I look, like, in the corner of, like, dead something dead random in my bedroom. And there'll be a spider there. And it's just, like, me instincts go, like, go and look quick, there's a spider. I don't know what I'm going to do when I live on my own. When I move out with the baby, with Elle, we're getting our own place, hopefully, this year. But when he goes away with work and stuff, I don't know what I'm going to do. Well, I've got Sage, we're taking Sage with us, because obviously she's ours. I don't think she's gonna like do nothing because she's dead friendly apart from when she's attacking me. So spiders and dying, and also just a quick one, something that no one speaks about, like something hitting the earth, like who knows. Like, I know they're like, oh, we've got astronauts and stuff that are in space and they can see like if there's anything floating near us, but like anything could hit the earth at any time and everything that has ever existed is completely gone. And then like thousands of years, if more life is then made on the earth or on a different planet, they'll never know that we existed. They'll never know that like we drove and like what maths we knew and stuff. That's dead random. Anyway, that's a completely different video. I am going to do a video on all the mad shit that goes on in my head, all the things I think about that no one really speaks about. Like, people are just asked about money and the education and stuff, like, yeah, but let's talk about real life. I think you should do it in school. Like, there should be a lesson called like real life. I know I'm going into it and I've just said I'm not. There should be a lesson called real life, shouldn't there? And you just talk about real life stuff that you don't learn in school. Look at my hands going. That you don't learn in school, like mental health and stuff. That, why isn't that a lesson that's like brought up all the time in school to let people know that it's okay to have like a bad mental health day or to feel horrible one day, do you know what I mean? Anyway, I'll do another video on that because that's something dead interesting that no one will watch, but I love to do. How do you cope being a military girlfriend? The answer to this is literally, I just do. I don't really have the choice to be able to cope or not, because you just do. I feel like it's hard, don't get me wrong, it's really hard. And like, if before I got with Elliot, I would have said, like, there's no way I could be with anyone in the military because I don't know how I'd deal with it. I don't know how you deal with them going away for so long or not being able to see them and, like, them living so far away. Like, I'm such a cling. Like, I want to see them all the time. Like, obviously, you do with your boyfriend. You want to see them often. I mean, I quite like having my own time, my own space, like, seeing my mates and do what I want to do. But it gets to a point where it's been, like, 3 or 4 weeks you still haven't seen them because they're, like, working or whatever. And you're just like, oh, I just want to see, yeah, it's dead annoying. But to be fair, there's never been a point where I haven't seen him for months and months. Like, the longest we haven't seen each other is 2 months. And I know that's a long time, like, for other people who, like, live together and see each other, like, every day. But doing that, now I know, well, I can do it. If he was to go away or have to go somewhere, it's like, I can do it, and I will do it, and I want to do it, because it means that we can be together, do you know what I mean? And it's been, like, 4 years this year. So, it's kind of just, like, something that you put up with, really, when you're in that situation. I think it's going to be hard when the baby's here, And that's why we're going to try and live together for when he arrives. So weird saying he, you know, because, like, we've only just found out, really, last month. Anyway. So, yeah, I think that'll be hard, like, if he gets deployed or has to go away or whatever. But he'll have me, won't you, son? Yeah, he'll have me, so it'll be okay. Just got to get through it. Got me family, got me friends. Everyone around me is so supportive. Like, none of my, like, close friends at home know what it's like. I mean, my dad joined the Marines as well when I was about two, so my mum's kind of got that experience. But I think because no one gets it, like, who I'm with, that's what's hard. Like, I can speak to someone and be, like, trying to explain how I feel and how I miss them and stuff, and they're like, oh, yeah, like, must be shit. And it's like, you just don't get it, like, at all. Like, do you know what I mean? My friends are so good about it. Like, they're so thoughtful and always keeping me busy, and it's, like, just what I need, really. Look at me going on. That's the answer to that. Where do you see yourself in 5 years? I love this question. So in 5 years, if it's like, I know you've got to be realistic, haven't you? But where do I see myself in 5 years? So I see myself obviously moved out. Hopefully that'll be this year for the baby and Elliot's sake. With little 5-year-old. Oh my God, he's going to be 5. No, he'll be like 4, won't he? All I want is a nice little house for us, obviously. Moved out with Elle and the baby. Been travelling, been completely out of lockdown, complete COVID's gone. That's something that we all need to hope for. So when we moved out, been on loads of holidays in that 5 years, and just, like, happy and healthy and, like, like, do you know what I mean? Like, I don't even know. I just want to be happy and healthy and in my own house, like, and just be living the life that, like, me dream life, going away all the time. Like, I'm such a holiday person. Like, I've been on holiday for a year because of COVID, and I know some people, like, don't go on holiday that often, but I go on about 3 holidays a year. And to some people, that's not a lot, but to me, that's, like, I need it. Like, I need to go on holiday, like, 2 or 3 times at least. Like, me and Elle go away, and then sometimes I'll go away with my family, like, my mum and that, if he's working during that time. Just happy, just healthy and happy with my little family, hopefully in the sun somewhere. Might move abroad, who knows? You're so positive and I want to know your trick to a happy life. My trick, I'm positive on social media because I want my page to be a positive place, not only for me, but for the people who are following me and see my story every day. Like, the last thing I want to be is negative, do you know what I mean? Like, life right now is negative, it's hard for everyone, but it's just something we've got all got to get on with. So let's all be in it together, do you know what I mean? Like, I'm just trying to make my social media as positive and realistic. Obviously, like, not everything's, like, amazing, like, on my story, and that I'm always, like, putting realistic stuff in my day-to-day life. It's always on my story and on my page and that, but I just want my page to be somewhere positive where people can go look out for me stories, full well knowing that I'm going to put, like, a good quote on there for the day, just to set everyone's day off, really, do you know what I mean? So for me to stay positive, I like the whole manifestation thing, and if you follow me on Instagram, yeah, you've probably seen that on my story, like, every day as well. I totally believe in it, and I believe that if you want something and you work towards it and you tell yourself you're gonna get it and you do everything you can to get it, you are gonna get it. So for example, if you want this gorgeous car and you've wanted it for ages, if you have that car on your lock screen on your phone, and you tell yourself every morning, you look in the mirror and you say your affirmation, whatever, and then you talk about the car that you want and you're setting your mind to it and you're putting money away for this car and you're doing everything you can for this car, you're going to get the car. Because why aren't you? Who's stopping you? Only you are stopping yourself. I'm going into one again. Look, I need to do another video on this. Yeah, so staying positive, manifesting. Some people don't believe in it. A lot of people don't. But I just like the idea of it. And it does help me. I think that's what helped me. Like, if I want to, I'll sit there with my little book and write all my little things in that I want from life. And a lot of them I've achieved because I've set my mind to it and I've made sure that I got it, because that's what I want from my life. Like, you've just got to set yourself and don't ever think, oh, I'll never get that, or because you won't. If you think you're never going to get it and you're like, oh, she's got something, but she's got loads of money, like, do you know what I mean? I could never get that. Well, then you're not going to get it. Do you know what I mean? Because you're telling yourself you're not going to, so you're not going to. So staying positive, quotes, those quotes that I put on my story, if you just follow the pages that I put onto my story, I see them every day and they literally get me through every day. I literally live for them. Sorry, Sage is just biting me toe. Next question, what is your takeaway order? Oh God, what am I getting? Chinese, probably. I'm so boring, you know, like when it comes to food. I think I'll get half rice, half chips, like half egg fried rice. But I don't really like the egg. I don't really eat the egg out of it. Or maybe chicken fried rice, actually. Half chips, half rice. Oh, what are them noodles called? Chow mein noodles. Oh my God. They are insane. Obviously chips. Not Papa Don's. Prawn crackers, yeah, gorgeous. But I do like a Domino's as well. And I know like Domino's is minging and that, but I like a Domino's. I'm actually not eating one this year. Or have I have. No, I think I have already, but I'm not eating one from now on. Next question is, what colour is your natural hair? So my natural hair is like dark brown. Have I got a picture? I do, but it's like behind me. Oh, here she is, Mrs. Sagey's. I'll put a photo in it, like, now. Okay, we're back. Yeah, my natural hair colour is dark brown. I don't know if you can probably see, like, my roots is, like, dark brown. And then I just got some of this blonde put in, which is, I don't even know if you can see it because of the lighting. But I like it. I just can't maintain it with the baby on the way, like, it's the hairdressers and stuff is so expensive. And also, I feel like I miss my brown, so... Do you have any fillers? Your lips are amazing. No, I literally have none at all because I'm absolutely petrified of needles. So yeah, these are my lips, thanks to my dad. Because my mum's got like the smallest lips, haven't you? But I've got new fillers and I don't plan on getting any really because it's not really my thing. And as I said, I'm petrified of needles, unless it's for a tattoo. Because I've got a few. I've got two. Yeah, I've got two tattoos. Do you have a favourite musician? So, like, is that, like, a singer, artist? I don't have a favourite, no. I'm proper weird with my music. Like, on me like songs, there's all random stuff, like Mac Miller, J. Cole, Kendrick Lamar. But then there's, like, Kelly Clarkson, you know, all, like, a proper random mix. Like, I don't have a set person who I listen to in the shower. It's just whoever. I like that Khaled as well. He's quite good for shower vibes. Because you can have a good old sing in the shower, can't you? Let me just make sure it's still recording. Yeah. What did you want to be when you were young? A teacher is the answer. I always wanted to be a teacher. I'd have me dolls. I was about four. I'd have me dolls all lined up in a row. And I'd be like, get me whiteboard and that out. And I'd be doing, like, being a pure teacher to these dolls the whole day. I would not get bored of it. And then when I got to about six, and I had this six or seven... I had this obsession with Hannah Montana, you know, like that Disney Channel programme, Miley Cyrus, isn't it? And my mum took me to see the video in the cinema of the Hannah Montana with the Jonas Brothers. And I was determined that I was going to be a singer with Hannah Montana. And my mum's got this video off me and I'm sitting there and she goes, right, what do you want to... Can you see Sage a little bit? What do you want to be when you're older? And I'm like, a singer. And my mum's like... With who? Who do you want to be a singer with? And I'm like, Hannah Montana. Like, pure thinking I was something else. Sage! Where's your ball gone? So yeah, that's what I wanted to be when I was younger. When's your due date? So, ow! Sage! She's scary sometimes, you know. Go and get your ball. Hang on, let me just get a ball. Wait. Sorry about that. When's your due date? So he's due on the 7th of May this year. And I came on my due date and Elliot was a bit late, so he could come on the due date. He might be early. I've just got this feeling that he's going to be early, which is a bit weird. And I'm like, I'm 23 weeks on Friday, so I'm a bit like, I need to pack my hospital bag. Because people on this Facebook group are like, when did you pack your hospital bags? And someone said, like, she's due like around the same time as me, and she said mine are packed in the car ready to go. And I was like, oh my God, I haven't even got a hospital bag. the baby needs a coming home outfit. And then I realise it's January and he's not due till May. So I'm kind of chill about it. What's your favourite colour? My favourite colour is pink. My favourite colour to wear is beige. I don't know if you can see, like, the pants are beige as well. These are so comfy, by the way. Anyway, that's off topic. Beige. Beige and black are my colours to wear. Mainly beige. And my favourite actual colour is pink. Would you choose a cold holiday abroad or hot? There is no answer to this other than a hot holiday. So I've been on about one or two cold holidays. I went to Switzerland and France with Elle, and then I've probably just been to like Wales or something as another one. No, I think I've only been to Switzerland and France as like a snowy holiday. That was in like one holiday. And it was nice, but it's just not for me. Like, I can't. If you said to me now, right, here's a grand, do you want to go on a ski? You can't go on a skiing holiday with a grand, can you? But do you want to go on a cold holiday to like somewhere mad with like Alaska? That'd be gorgeous. Or do you want to go on a hot holiday? I'd literally snore you when you said cold, because I can't do the cold. I hate it. I hate the cold. I hate winter. Winter outfits are nice. Not when you're pregnant though, because you proper have to wrap up in the winter because I get freezing. But it's so hard to layer when you're pregnant because you just get all like stuffy and like not in fit you, and it's just horrible. So a hot holiday. Don't know why I can't just say hot. Like, why do I need to explain? So random. What radio station do you listen to in the car? I only know Radio 1, laughing face. That is the most randomest question I've been asked, I think. In the car, a lot of the time I just plug my phone in and put like something random on like one of my playlists. But I listen to Kistry and Capital. I listen to Capital because I'm always entering the competitions, and nowhere do I lie, the doctors rang me the other day and I had entered the competition and the answer was the Grinch, yeah. So I answered the phone and I went, Capital, give me the cash, down the phone. And the doctors were like, hello, is that Jasmine? And I was like, oh my God, like how embarrassing. I was like, sorry, I'm waiting for the phone call to win this like 25 grand, whatever it was. So yeah, listen to Capital and Kistry because it's got all the old tunes on, hasn't it? Or plug my phone in with the Spotify. Do you have a nickname? I love the name Jasmine. Oh, thank you. Just Jazz, really. I just get called Jazz or like Jazzy, or it depends who I'm talking to. Like, my mum calls me Babe or Poppet, and like my nan calls me Flo, and my auntie calls me Jasmina. I've got quite a few for family, but my nickname for everyone else is just like Jazz. Right, so another question I get a lot is, will you do like a room tour of the baby's room? And yeah, I will do. I'll do a video on that. Like a proper room tour for him once his room is done. So probably within like the next month or two, really. Depends on COVID, what I can get. But I will do a room tour, and also a baby haul of all of his stuff is a request of one, especially on his little Instagram. So I've made him his own private one for family and friends, so I can put like photos up that I would put on mine, but I don't want to hammer my Instagram with baby stuff, do you know what I mean? So I will do a baby boy clothing haul where I got the stuff from, and that for other mums as well. And I'll do a little room tour. That's what it's called, a room tour. Is that what I said before? I don't know. And yeah, and then I'm gonna do my more baby stuff on here as well as normal stuff. But yeah, I've got quite a few requests of like videos to do, so I'm gonna get them filmed and uploaded within the next few weeks to stay busy. I think I'm gonna try and do one to two videos per week during this lockdown. And then I'm gonna try and like, if it like goes all right and the videos are all right, then I might just carry on for a bit once he's here to give me something to do. And obviously, I'll be like, here he is. It'd be so cute. Me and the baby doing a little YouTube video. Right, so I don't know how long this video has been by the time I've edited everything. So guys, thank you so much for just like watching this video. Spending like, I don't even know how long it's going to be. Probably like 25 minutes or something of your time watching me just talk. So yeah, thank you.